Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, I'll be showing you how to paint one of the linemen from the Norse Blood Bowl team up to battle ready. Now, before we begin, we need to give our modeler here an undercoat. As you can see here, I have used Mechanicus Standard Grey. And now we can start with our colours. The first colour that we'll be using today is Thousand Suns Blue for the blue armour. So we're going to be taking it out of the pot and then we can just thin it down with a touch of water from our palette. Just getting our brush to a nice point and then we can start applying it to our armour. Now we just want it to be neat as we can, as we're going to avoid trying to get it on the edges and anywhere else. But don't worry, if you do get it on anywhere, we're going to cover those with some other colours. And with that Thousand Suns Blue now dry, we can move on to some more base coats. For these, we'll be using Avalon Sunset for the yellow markings, Night Lord's Blue for the dark blue details, and Catchkin Flesh for the brown details. So let's get on with the Avalon Sunset. So we're going to pick it out of the pot, and we need to thin it down a little bit more than we normally would do, just so it's nice and smooth as we apply it on top of those panels. So we will just start by doing some short lines. Don't worry if you make it a little bit too lumpy or if you think it's not as straight as it could be. Don't worry, we can tidy it up with some more Thousand Suns Blue afterwards. And now that our yellow markings are now dry, we can move on to some Night Lord's Blue for all the blue details. So we're going to start off onto the trousers and anywhere else that you think would be a nice shade of dark blue. And now with that dry, we can move on to some Catechan Flesh for the hair and any leather straps as well. So just make sure you also get that beard as well if they have a beard. And with those base coats now dry, we can move on to our last base coats. For these, we'll be using Grey Seer for the skin, wrapping and fur, Retributor Armour for the gold detail, and Iron Hand Steel for the silver detail. So let's get on with that Grey Seer. So I'm just going to get it out of the pot. I'm going to make sure it's not too thick, because we want this to be a nice smooth base coat. So we're just going to grab a little bit more out and just a touch of water. And then we can start applying it to our areas of our model. So we just want to make sure that we don't get it onto any areas that we've already painted. But don't worry, at this stage, we can always go back with any of those colours that we've already applied. And if you think it's a little bit too thin, don't worry, you can always add a second coat afterwards. Now that our Grey Seer is now dry, we can move on to Retributor Armour for our gold details. So just be very careful and take your time with this, as a lot of these edges are quite small. So just use the tip of your brush and just go around slowly. And with the Retributor Armour now dry, we can move on to the Iron Hand Steel, and we're going to use this on any silver areas. So we're going to go for this buckler, any belt buckles. I'll also be using it on the base helmet and those runic stone markings. Now with those base coats finished, we can move on to some shades and contrasts. For this, we'll be starting off with some Nun Oil, and we'll be applying that to the silver and the blue areas. So we're just going to go straight into the pot. We're not going to thin it down, but we're going to make sure we don't get too much on our brush, and we can start applying it to those areas. So we're going to make sure that we're going to be nice and neat and make sure that we're not going to get on any fur or any wrappings. We're just going to be nice and gentle. And remember to do that rock and the helmet that sit on the base as well. And with the shade now dry, we can move on to those contrasts. This will be using Saigor Brown, thinned down with contrast medium for the brown and gold details, Skeleton Horde for the wrappings, Gilliman Flesh for the skin, and Griff Charger Grey for the fur. So let's get on with thinning that Saigor Brown. So we're going to take one brushful, and then another one as well. You may find that you need a little bit more, but we'll mix up first. Then we're going to wash our brush, make sure it's nice and dry. And then we can take a small amount, so one brushful of Saigor Brown, and we're going to just mix that in. If you find it's still a little bit too dark, you can always wash off your brush and get some more. So we don't overload our golden brown details. There we go, that looks really good right now. And get your brush to a nice point, don't overload your brush either. And now we're going to start applying it. So you just want to be really careful with those gold details, so I'm going to start off with the brown. So I'm just going to fill in the beard and the hair and any leather straps and boots. And then we can just be really careful with the gold details. So I'm just going to fill this area here. If you find that you've got too much of the Cyagor brown on the gold, you can always clean off your brush and dab it away gently. And with that now dry, we can move on to the skeleton horde. We're going to use that on the wraps on the top half, so like around the wrists and around the bottom of the legs as well. And with that skeleton horde now dry, we can move on to the Gilliman flesh for our skin tone. And we're just going to be careful, and we're not going to apply too much in some areas. We're going to move it around quite a bit. If you find that it's too dark in some areas, you can always clean off your brush and take it off with a clean one. And with our skin now dry, we can apply that Griff Charger Grey to any of our fur areas. Now that those contrasts are now dry, we can finish off with the base. This will be using a Ghrelin Earth, and we'll be using our texture tool to apply this. So we're going to dip it out of the pot just by using the wide shovel. So we're going to get a lovely scoop of it, and then we're going to put it straight onto the base. Now, we'll find that you probably need quite a bit, so don't worry, just grab some more. But we're going to start by slowly patting it out so it can start cracking up. Now, this may take a little bit of time to dry, roughly about an hour. And now with our texture dry, we have painted the rim of our base in a colour to match the rest of our team. In this instance, we have used Steel Legion Drab. And now our Norse lineman is ready to go. And there you have it, our Norse lineman is now battle ready, and he can't wait to crack some skulls on the pitch. Now just a couple of things to remember while you're painting. Keep your paints nice and thin when you're applying your base coats, and don't overload your brushes with contrasts and shades. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Norse Blood Bowl team, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!